is AI inherently ethical? I think AI isn't inherently ethical. I think AI isn't inherently unethical, but AI, like any technology, also isn't neutral. What AI will be like is very much up to us. We're not on rails here. It's our decision to figure out which direction we actually want to go. I'm Johannes Himmelreich. I'm a professor in the Maxwell School of Citizenship and Public Affairs at Syracuse University, and I work on AI governance and ethics. So today I'm happy to talk about the ethics of AI, governance and policy issues around AI and technology. Let's start with the first question. How do you define artificial intelligence? Well, here's the official definition. Artificial intelligence is our attempt as humans to build systems that process information and interact with the world in a way that normally requires human intelligence.
I can interact with humans in different ways. I am still learning the best ways to talk with people, but I think I'm getting better.
After all, many concepts like artificial intelligence or democracy or fairness are always really hard to define. And when it comes to artificial intelligence, it's not only so much what we mean by artificial intelligence, but that we're actually interested in figuring out what does artificial intelligence mean for us. Next question, what's the philosophy of data science and why is it important? Well, first of all, data science is about making good decisions. So data science is basically the computational analysis of information to support decision making. And in a way, that's already where the problems start, because making good decisions is hard. And even if you say, you know, we want to make predictions as in data science, we want to figure out, is there going to be a flood? Is this stock going to go up? The question is not so much what it means to get it right, but what it means to get it wrong and which kinds of mistakes are worse than others. So, for example, missing a cancer sign in an x-ray is much worse than having too many false positives. So not all mistakes are created equal. Next question. What are the ethical concerns of AI making life-changing decisions, such as in hiring, criminal sentencing, or medical diagnoses? I actually think AI here is a bit like a magnifying glass. It helps us see issues that have always been there in much more detail and much more prominently than we used to before. So I think some of the ethical concerns that we associate with AI are actually problems that have been there all along, but now we see them much more clearly than we did before. Next question. What does ethical AI look like? And is AI inherently ethical? Well, so let's start with the latter part of that question. AI isn't inherently ethical, AI isn't inherently unethical, but AI, like any technology, also isn't neutral. The main thing to realize is that what AI will be like is very much up to us. We're not on rails here. It's our decision to turn left or to turn right and figure out which direction we actually want to go. To the question of what does ethical AI look like, I think we need the space to have a good process to build the ethical AI, to involve the right people. And there's a real risk that if we feel we are in an AI race, that space will get smaller and we won't have the time to focus on the process and do it right. All right, next question. Because AI systems inherit biases from human data, is it possible to create a truly fair and unbiased AI? That's a super interesting question. So first thing to note is that bias and discrimination aren't the same thing. A second thing that's really important to note is that oftentimes it's not human biases that translate into the data, but oftentimes it's data or impression that we have from the world that translate into biases. So for example, if you were to guess who's more likely to have ovarian cancer, men or women, you'd probably think women are more likely to have ovarian cancer. That's a form of implicit bias, but it's a helpful one insofar as it tracks the data. Next question. Who should be held accountable when an AI system causes harm? The developers, the users, or the AI itself? Why not all of them? Sometimes we think about accountability as akin to blame or punishment, but I think that's a really narrow perspective to take on accountability. If we think about accountability in terms of responsibility, we should all be responsible for harms that AI causes. Next question. Should AI systems have the ability to override human decisions in high-stakes situations, for example, self-driving cars, deciding who to save in an accident? So I think, yeah, AI should override human decision-making. And I think that we should be aware of our own weaknesses and be happy to let AI do the job once we realize AI is better at it. The problem is we are bad at acknowledging our weaknesses. We need to know when is the moment to hand over control to the AI, so that we don't need to get in a situation to be overridden by AI against our will. Last question. What are some promising future developments in artificial intelligence? So as a philosophy researcher, I'm really optimistic and excited to see what difference AI is going to make to philosophy, to helping everybody philosophize, think about their lives in a better way, and helping philosophers like me write better papers and create better insights. Many teachers are really worried about their students using AI. I think it's a great tool to use. If you can figure out how to use it for your thinking, then AI has done its job. The main part of the thinking and deciding what you value is still something you have to do for yourself. So AI might write the essay for you about whether you should eat meat or not, or whether it's okay to skip your best friend's birthday. But that is only an answer. The question is it the answer that you can get behind yourself? And that's something that AI can't answer for you.